I mean, you know, you have gold and silver coins, you know, and you can also work with the Perth Mint, get some gold out of the country. We do. I think you're fine doing something like that, you know.
You might recommend that versus, you know, if I'm worried about holding the weakening dollar fund and the
yeah, or you know, you could just, or you know, you could pick. You know, I think so. I mean, I think if the dollar does weaken, ultimately what you're going to see is gold price strengthen. So I think it's kind of the same trade.
Okay, I got one more kind of odd question for you. I was talking with parents, and my stepfather had his 401k in Euro Pacific Capital, and he just recently switched it. What can I tell them? How can I sell them on putting their 401ks into Euro Pacific?
Well, I mean, I don't know. Why don't you has he read any of my books?
No, but I've been looking into picking those up.
Yeah, that's what I would do. I'd introduce them to me through the book, you know, let them look at that, maybe give them the website, let them look at some of the videos, read some of my stuff, and then have them call and talk to one of the brokers to find out a little bit more about what we do. And, you know, you try to educate them, and, you know, I'm sure we can educate them. And ultimately, I'm sure we'll be able to win the account because I think, you know, once somebody becomes familiar with the situation and what we're doing, I mean, I think it's a no-brainer. I mean, what to do with your money.
All right, Peter. Well, I appreciate it.
Thanks for the call, and appreciate the referral if we get your dad on board. Next call. Actually, let me take a quick break. I want to play a commercial and catch my breath, and we'll be right back for the second half of the show.
Euro Pacific Capital is an independent brokerage firm on a mission to inform its client base and prospective clients about economic and market events that could affect their financial security.
Hello?
Euro Pacific Capital seeks to provide solutions
to protect
our clients and their families from the U.S. government and its inflationary practices. The time to act is now, while you still have the opportunity to get your money out of the dollar. It's legal to do so, and after a consultation with one of Euro Pacific's brokers, you will understand how this decision could ensure your financial security. We offer a full array of services ranging from retirement and trust accounts to complete financial planning, checking accounts with or without debit cards, and life insurance, even annuities. With our independent, no-nonsense investment advice that's a cut above the run-of-the-mill commentary that has passed for research for far too long on Wall Street, we suspect investors will find a home at Euro Pacific Capital.
All right, we are back. I think next up is Paul, calling from Missouri.
Yes, good evening, Peter. Thanks for taking my call. My question is, what currency would you place in an emergency fund? And my second part of that is, I'm trying to get my father and my grandmother to get out of the dollar. How would I
Yeah, well, as far as emergency funds, I mean, I don't know, the dollar could obviously be one of the currencies. I mean, you're talking about short-term emergencies, you know, and so you might want to have a basket of currencies that would include the dollar in that type of emergency fund. And obviously, if the dollar gets wiped out, you know, if you have some other currencies like the yen or the Swiss franc in there, the yen has been very strong recently. So those are probably good currencies to have in your fund. And if at the time an emergency comes up, if the dollar is strong, then you don't use, you know, you leave the yen alone or the Swiss franc alone, and you simply, fund the emergency spending with your dollars. And if the dollar is completely destroyed, well, you know, then you draw on the yen or the Swiss.
Okay. And my second question is, my father and my grandmother, I'm trying to get them out of their dollar because they have substantially more assets than I do. Besides showing them your books or anything else, how would I assure them that it's not as big as of a risk to invest in some of these bargain companies over in Asia?
Well, I mean, they just have to understand that. I mean, you know, as I said, they can read the books and understand the principles of investing. And, you know, you minimize your risk, you know, in long-term investing by buying stocks cheap, by collecting good dividends. And, you know, in this market, I mean, everything is going to be risky when you look at it from, you know, the prism of a day-to-day trading band. I mean, there's, you know, right now, you know, everything is going down. I mean, there's no diversification that can help you because whatever you own anywhere in the world, you know, if it has a symbol, it's going down. But this is a unique circumstance. But, you know, the fact that stocks have been beaten down ultimately means there's a lot less risk to buying. I mean, in the long run, in the short run, because of the volatility and what's going on, there's more risk. So it means that if you're a short-term investor and you buy now, you run a greater risk of losing. But if you're a long-term investor and you buy now, I think you have a much better chance of profiting and a much smaller chance of losing. And as far as on the currencies, I think, you know, you just have to understand that, you know, there's two types of risks. You know, if you have your money in dollars, you know, supposedly, at least if it's in U.S. Treasuries, let's say, or in, if it's stuffed under your mattress, you know, the risk you run is not that you lose the dollar. I mean, assuming they're not stolen from your mattress, the risk that you run is that the dollar loses its value. So you can have $1 million and you can keep them very safe, and, you know, you can still have your $1 million, but, you know, if it costs $1 million to buy a pack of chewing gum, it doesn't mean that you did a good job, that you preserved any wealth by just not losing any dollars. You know, if you understand that there's a lot of risk in the dollar and you decide you want to hold other currencies or other assets, then you risk losing dollars. I mean, if you put $1 million into euros, you know, any given day, you know, you might only have $900,000 or $800,000. There's a chance that when you own the euro, you can lose dollars. But now, but from a longer-term perspective, what you've done is you said, look, I think my purchasing power is safer in euros and in dollars, and it's probably a smart bet. But, you know, you can build a portfolio of a basket of currencies. You can include foreign stocks and whatever you put in there, and you just have to understand that what you're doing is you're trading the risk of the dollar losing value for the risk of losing dollars. And that's what I'd rather have. I would rather have foreign currencies and foreign assets. I don't care if they temporarily go down, because I know in the long run it's the dollar that's going to get destroyed, and I don't want to own it.
Yes. Singapore dollar and Australian dollar, I'd put those in my basket of emergency fund currencies.
Yeah, Singapore dollar is really good. I mean, it's, you know, and Aussie dollar, you know, has been beaten up a lot recently. So my guess is there's not that much downside left in the Aussie and Kiwi. You know, they're starting to cut rates over there. They cut again recently. But, you know, the rates are still many, many times what they are in the U.S., and I don't think there's that many more rate cuts coming over there. Meanwhile, I think a lot of these rate cuts, I think the damage to the currencies have already been done. I mean, these currencies are down 40%. I don't think there's a lot more downside. I mean, I could be wrong, but I don't think so. Anyway, but thanks for the call. And next up is it Gabe in Texas?
Hi, hello, Peter. How are you?
Good, good. How are you?
I'm well. My question is, I've got about $65,000 in cash, and the main question is that I own a piece of property in central Mexico. It's prime real estate. It's worth about $400,000 with the currency exchange rate right now, with the peso and the dollar. And I was planning on holding that land for about 10 to 15 years, so that it appreciated in value, because they're developing that part of the city now. The government.
But what size? Is it just raw land right now?
It's raw land. Yeah, but it's a hectare of land, which is about 4 acres.
Yeah, I mean, what I would try to do, probably, I mean, I don't know all the circumstances, but if you can actually sell that land, if you can get a decent price for it, I think rather than sitting on raw land and hoping something happens, you know, if you can, you know, buy real estate, you know, buy some of these, you know, commercial REITs around the world that have just been absolutely destroyed, like the one I, you know, talked about in Hong Kong, you know, which is yielding 27%, you know, why not pick up a fully developed piece of property that you can get dirt cheap, as opposed to holding an undeveloped property and hoping something happens? I think that there are just so many good bargains right now for already developed properties with good tenants on board that you can buy for next to nothing, that it doesn't seem that it makes sense to speculate on raw land when you've got the better use for the money.
Okay. And the other thing is that my cash right now is $65,000, and I was thinking about just putting it all into silver. I don't know what you think about that.
Well, you know, it depends. I mean, I'm very bullish on silver. I mean, silver is under $10 an ounce right now, and I think it represents a lot of value here. You know, it was as high as 20. So it depends. You know, if you don't want to have all your eggs in one basket, if that's all the cash you have, I mean, you might not want to put it all in silver. But, you know, I think silver is got a lot of potential, you know, and it'll probably do better than most things that you want to speculate on. But, you know, it depends. I mean, when you're